Hello. So here we are talking about this bombastic budget by our finance minister. Especially if you talk about the current situation, you know, we have been living in lockdown for almost 6-7 months. Global economy going up and down, and India also gave almost as high as 20 lakh crore as a stimulus to the economy. And all of this resulted in a government ending up at a 9.5% fiscal deficit. However, the government still bit the bullet and went ahead, and they're talking about 15% plus nominal rate of growth. That is really very, very audacious move. And they're also saying that the next fiscal, which is FY 2022, the fiscal deficit will be under 6.8%, which is still very commendable. So if you talk about 15.5% nominal rate of GDP, then what will happen? A lot of companies will start growing aggressively. Government has also said that they'll do aggressive capex. The private sector will start, doing capex. They'll invest. This will create a lot of jobs. This will also help the ancillary industry, and maybe it will create a multiplier effect. So what we were thinking in 2007, that the Indian economy will grow at 10% plus for next few years, this might happen now. So it is maybe a new India from Atmanirbhar to Atmashakti.
Correct. So if we talk about this budget, this was actually the budget that was that has laid foundation for the previous budget.
Wow.
So that the foundation of the last budget, the government which they dreamt about the 5 trillion economy. So now the foundation was how the capex cycle will move ahead.
Correct.
So going ahead, like in this budget, what government focused was on capital expenditure.
Correct.
So in FY 22, if we see the target budget of the expenditure part, so it comes around 34.8 lakh crores.
Wow.
Where the capex part is around 5.5 lakh crore. So this turns to be 13% of the total expenditure.
Very impressive numbers.
And now in this expenditure, we see mainly the boost is towards the infrastructure side.
Correct. Plus, government has also given boost. Suddenly, government said, you know, that we also need to focus on healthcare. So, government has also went ahead and has done some ambitious allocation towards the healthcare sector.
Yes. So, now comes the funding part of the infrastructure.
Yes. So, where will the money come from?
Yeah.
So, government also said that they will go to the market, and government is fairly confident. I mean, this is what they had discussed with our Reserve Bank, that they'll be able to raise the money.
Yeah, so especially for raising the money, they have created DFIs. So DFIs is Development Financial Institutions,
which will help them to fund this kind of a growth.
Yeah, so the initial funding from the government side will be 20,000 crores.
Wow.
Where the government target is in the next 3 years, the lending portfolio from DFIs will be around 1 lakh crores. So that itself is suggesting like almost 5 times.
So, but I am very curious now, since from a perspective of Aam Aadmi, that what is Aam Aadmi going to get in this budget?
See, Aam Aadmi, in the sense, if the growth happens, if the infrastructure, highways, roads, everything, you know, build up in the coming 4 to 5 years.
Yes.
As per the government, like they have also allocated to various states, like say Assam, West Bengal, they have allocated 95,000 crores.
Wow.
For Assam, they have allocated around 35,000 crores. So these are suggestive. If the highways and all, you know, the construction infrastructure part is good, then of course the allied sectors, say reality or multiplexes or schools, hospitals, all out of automatically they, every sector grows.
So the government is also addressing, you know, since we have the youngest and the highest number of people working in the working age category.
Yeah.
It's highest in the world. So if that happens and if people start getting jobs, so people will start buying two-wheelers, people will start getting into affordable or non-affordable houses, and maybe they'll buy air conditioners, the consumption will shoot up and the economy will They'll have a multiplier effect.
Yeah, so that is what the government focuses. So this government focuses on long-term approach rather than going for short-term. So they have not focused on revenue expenditure. What they have seen is the capital expenditure.
Correct.
Because that will of course create a multiplier effect. If the job increases, people consumption will increase, and automatically all the sectors will do well.
And also from the taxpayer's perspective, that they have done really well. You know, they have exempted. I mean, they have given a provision where people above 75 age can exempt filing for the income tax.
Yeah.
If they get if they are only living on the pension income and the bank interest.
Yeah.
So a lot of things to distribute. The government has really balanced this budget. I mean, not only balanced but also a very audacious and very bold step by the government to drive the economy.
Mm-hmm.
And since you know the sun is rising in the east, and this is what we have been reading from the Western papers, that so China has played a very good role. Maybe India will play a very dominant role in this decade.
Yes.
So
one more thing I wanted to point out, like in this pandemic, what like common people suffered was from the loan perspective. So the banks had faced a very, you know, NPA sort of stress assessment were created.
Correct.
So now what happened, that because the banks had such a, you know, stress asset in their book, they were unable to do the capitalization part.
Right.
So what they did, they created a separate bad bank sort of thing, where the you know all the PSU banks.
All the stress asset will be addressed, cleansing moment.
Yeah.
For the bank and lending institution, they can form their own separate arm to.
And then the fresh lending can go ahead.
And their pocket size can increase to like,
yes,
wow,
yes,
that's
yes.
A great step by the government. So
yeah.
I'm looking forward to this budget. I mean, I've not seen this kind of budget since 1991.
Exactly.
So I mean, maybe we'll see a great India in our lifetime.
In the next 10 years.
Thank you.
Sure.
Thank you.
Thank you.